Another carboxylic acid derivative is the amide functional group, and you'll hear many different ways to pronounce this functional group. So I usually say amide, but I've heard amides or amide or however you want to say it. To me, it's not really that big of a deal. It seems to be more where you're from is in terms of how you pronounce it. And so if our goal is to name this two carbon amide over here on the right, let's start with the two carbon carboxylic acid over here on the left. So we have two carbons. And if we think about the IUPAC name, right, so two carbons, this would be ethanoic acid. So ethanoic acid. To name the corresponding amide, we're going to drop the ending. So we're going to drop the oic acid and add on amide. So let's go ahead and write that. So we would drop the oic acid and add on amide. So ethanamide or ethanamide is what you could call this molecule over here on the right. Of course, most people don't call this ethanoic acid. Most people call this acetic acid. So if we think about naming this derived from acetic acid, let's go ahead and write that down. So acetic acid, like that. If we drop the ending this time, we don't have an extra O, right? So we just have this IC. So we're going to drop the IC acid and add amide onto that. So we would make acetamide, right? If we think about over here, or acetamide, however you want to say it. So once again, think about dropping the ending and adding amide on. So acetamide is an example of a primary amide. So this is a primary amide. And the way I like to think about this is this nitrogen here is bonded to only one carbon. And so that makes the carbon right here. So that makes this primary. If we want to think about naming this one down here, this time the nitrogen is bonded to two carbons, right? So the carbon in our carbonyl and also this carbon over here. And so this one is an example of a secondary amide, so a nitrogen bonded to two carbons. If we think about the parent carboxylic acids over here, one, two, three carboxylic acid, three carbons in this carboxylic acid. So the IUPAC name would be propanoic acid. So let's go ahead and write out propanoic acid. We're going to use this as the base for the amide on the right. So once again, we're going to drop the oic acid ending, just like we did up here. Right, so we drop the oic acid ending and add on amide. So we have propanamide. So let's go ahead and write that. So over here on the right, we would have propanamide or propanamide, like that. And then that takes care of it, if you will, this portion of the molecule. Okay, so now we still have this methyl group right here to worry about, and that methyl group is coming off of this nitrogen here. So we have a methyl group coming off of this nitrogen, and the way we show that is to put an N here, and then a methyl. So N-methylpropanamide tells us that we have a methyl group coming off of the nitrogen in our amide, and so that's how it's done. All right, let's look at some more examples. So two more examples for amides right here, and let's see how to name them. So let's start with the one on the left. So for this one, if I think about the carboxylic acid, it'd be a one, two, three, four. So four carbon carboxylic acid, the IUPAC name is butanoic acid. So we drop the oic acid part and add on amide, so it'd be butanamide. So let's go ahead and write that in. So this would be butanamide. And then we have to think about what else is attached to this nitrogen here, right? So the nitrogen in our amide right here has a methyl group here and another methyl group here. So two methyl groups. So this time we're going to write N-N-dimethyl. So we have two methyl groups. Each one of those methyl groups is attached to that nitrogen. So N-N-dimethylbutanamide would be the name for this molecule. In terms of classifying it, right? So in terms of classifying this amide here, this would actually be a tertiary amide because this nitrogen is attached to one, two, three other carbons, and so it's a tertiary amide. All right, let's look at naming one more. So this one over here on the right. And if I think about the carboxylic acid from which this was derived, right? So you have to use your imagination a little bit, right? So if I think about this portion, right, instead of the nitrogen here, if I had an OH, that would be benzoic acid. So I'm just going to go ahead and write that right here. So benzoic acid. we know we're going to drop the ending, right? We're going to drop the oic acid part and add amide, so it'd be benzamide. So let's go ahead and write that. So as our parent name here, so we would have benzamide here. And then let's think about what else we have. We have a nitrogen, right? And we have a methyl group, one methyl group bonded to that nitrogen. And then we have another methyl group over here on the ring. So let's go ahead and number the ring and see where our other methyl group is, right? So our other methyl group, if we number our ring, this would be carbon 1 if we think about this as being like benzoic acid, right? So if we're numbering our ring, this would be carbon 1. And then carbon 2, carbon 3, and carbon 4. And so we have a methyl group at carbon 4, and we also have a methyl group coming off of our nitrogen. So this time, we're going to write, let me go ahead and write right here. This would be N4-dimethyl, right? So we have N4-dimethylbenzamide as our name for this molecule. So notice the difference, right? So here we have a methyl group on our nitrogen right here, and we have a methyl group coming off of carbon 4. So that's where our dimethyl comes from. For this one, we have N and another N because both of our methyl groups are coming off of the nitrogen in the example on the left. And so it's just kind of useful to contrast these two molecules when we're thinking about nomenclature. In terms of physical properties of amides, let's look at a little diagram here showing acetamide, right? So we have our amide right here. And physical properties in terms of what state of matter is this, acetamide is actually a solid at room temperature and pressure. And so this is a solid. It has a lot of hydrogen bonding, right? So we could think about some hydrogen bonding here. We could think about some hydrogen bonding here. There are lots of opportunities for hydrogen bonding, right? So partial negative oxygen, partial positive hydrogen bonded to this nitrogen, right, which is withdrawing some electron density from this hydrogen. So lots of opportunities for hydrogen bonding, right, makes acetamide a solid at room temperature. And so its melting point turns out to be approximately 82 degrees Celsius. So that's its melting point. Its boiling point is actually much higher. So somewhere around 221 degrees, so higher. So this is actually the melting point, and the boiling point being much higher due to the very strong intermolecular forces that are present between amide molecules. In terms of solubility of amides in water, small amides are definitely soluble, right? So if I think about water coming along, let's go ahead and draw water in here. Water is a polar molecule, so partial negative, partial positive. So like dissolves like, this polar amide, this will dissolve in polar water. You could think about some hydrogen bonding going on right here. So like dissolves like. And there's also a resonance property to amides, right? So I won't get too much into resonance, but there's a lone pair of electrons on this nitrogen which can move into here, pushing these electrons off onto the oxygen, giving you a plus one formal charge on your nitrogen and a negative one formal charge on your oxygen. And so amides can be polar as well. And so this also can explain the solubility of acetamide in water here. So small amides can be soluble in water, but of course, as we've been discussing in these videos, as you increase this R group, as you increase the number of carbons, if you turn this into R group, the more carbons you have, the more nonpolar character you have, so you would decrease the solubility of amides as you do that. So we'll talk much more about the resonance structure for amides in future videos, because it's extremely important for things like reactivity and chemical reactions.